Hi, it's Jack Kalucki from Nitrex, and I'll touch on the basic mechanisms of gas nitriding and nitrocarburizing, as well as the benefits of those treatments. When gas nitriding was invented by accident, the metallurgists intended to avoid oxidation in the furnace and used ammonia instead of air, not understanding what happened. The surfaces were not oxidized, however, they became very hard. Ammonia naturally breaks up at very high temperatures, near 930 degrees Celsius or roughly 1700 degrees Fahrenheit. However, in the presence of a catalyst, it will break up at a much lower temperature, and iron is such a catalyst. This is precisely what was discovered by chance by Adolf Machlet. A reaction between nitrogen, iron, and alloying elements such as chromium or aluminum. But what happens when ammonia breaks up or dissociates? Ammonia, or NH3, breaks up into nitrogen and three atoms of hydrogen. This results in a nascent or atomic nitrogen. For a very brief moment, nitrogen can and will react with iron and any alloying elements. Then nitrogen will recombine in molecules, chemically stable N2 molecules we find in ambient air. At first, the reaction will produce a quasi-ceramic skin on the surface of steel parts. This skin is generally called compound or white layer and may contain up to 10% nitrogen per weight and combined with iron and other elements. It is hard, resists friction and corrosion. However, the most important function of the white layer is its ability to allow the transfer, also called diffusion, of nitrogen into the steel structure. When diffusion takes place, nitrogen will create compressive stress, similar to hardness created when inflating a tire, because in essence, you have more molecules, more matter in the same volume. When nitrogen reacts with common alloying elements, chromium or aluminum, it will chemically bind with them, resulting in chromium or aluminum nitrides. These nitrides increase the toughness of a component. It took a while for Adolf Machlet and other metallurgists such as Fry to understand and quantify those basic mechanisms behind an accidental invention. Yes, indeed, nitrogen is soluble in steel and iron. Nitrocarburizing is a process derived from nitriding by the addition of a carbon-bearing gas, such as carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, or natural gas, for instance. It was developed to help create a thicker white layer and improve hardness on low-carbon steels, also called mild steels. The most exciting takeaway from an engineering point of view is that nitriding can be done at relatively low temperatures. While it does not affect core hardness or characteristics, nitriding improves surface qualities such as hardness, wear resistance, and coefficient of friction. It also improves the load-bearing ability of treated parts by providing an underlying diffusion layer. Click on the screen right now to watch another video on nitriding and nitrocarburizing. Make sure to leave a like or comment and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.